Now let us learn with one example. A, B and C were partners in a firm under dissolution. Their respective capitals were 5,000, 3,000 and 1,000 and they shared profit and losses in ratio of 2:2:1. The undistributed profits were 2,500 and realization loss amount to ₹8,000. Questions. Show partners' capital accounts assuming that C was insolvent and was unable to contribute anything towards his capital deficiency. Apply Gardner versus Murare rule. In this problem, balance sheet is not given, but details were provided: capitals of partners A, B and C, undistributed profits were 2,500 and realization loss ₹8,000. In such a cases, we need to prepare first balance sheet to find out the amount cash in hand. So here A capital ₹5,000, B capital ₹3,000, C capital ₹1,000. Undistributed profits were given. Profits comes under liabilities. Profit and loss 2,500. Total 11,500. Asset side, realization loss amount is given. So balancing figure here is cash in hand, that is 11,500 minus 8,000. So this is balancing figure in this case. Now calculate the capital ratio of solvent partners. Here solvent partners are A and B. They are the solvent partners. So capitals as per balance sheet in the ratio of 2:2:1. Reserve fund. In this case, reserve fund is not given, but undistributed, we have undistributed profits 2,500. That is accumulated profit 2,500. So here, before this, we will take the capital of A, 5,000 and B, 3,000. Now we'll distribute this accumulated profit in 2:2:1 ratio. Here 2,500 into 2 divided by 5. Similarly for B, 2,500 into 2 divided by 5. So this stands 6,000 and 4,000. If reserves given, add, and accumulated profit, add. If accumulated loss is given, that needs to be subtracted. Now here we have this 6,000 and 4,000. That is capital before, just stood before dissolution. 6000 and 4000. So here ratio is 6 is to 4 or 3 is to 2. Two twos are 4, two threes are 6. So your capital ratio is 3 is to 2. Now our next step is to prepare insolvent account. So here C is an insolvent and his capital is 1000. My balance brought down. So profit is share into 2 is to 2 is to 1, that is 2500 in this case, 1000 here for B, 1000 and remaining balances, that is 500 for C. So in the problem, realization loss is given. Realization loss, that is 8000. So 8000 in, again it is distributed in profit and loss ratio. 2 realization loss. So this returns 8000. Into 1 divided by 6. So this will return 1600. So there is capital deficiency of rupees 100. This 100 of C is insolvent. This has been shared by A and B in their capital ratio by A capital. Similarly, by B capital, so here amount is 100, 100 into the ratio is 3 is to 2, so 3 by 5, so this will return. For A, it will return 60, for B, 40. Now, prepare solvent partners account. By balance brought down. So in this case, capital A 5000 and B 3000. B 3000 by profit and loss, that is shared in 2 is to 2 is to 1, for A this is 1000, this B 1000, two realization loss. So realization loss, that is 8000. 8000 is shared into their profit and loss ratio, that it returns 3200. So here 8000 into 2/5. For A, similarly for B, it returns 3200 and insolvent account 1600. Now here, since here is a loss on realization, so the solvent partners have brought cash of rupees 3200 each, that is 3200 equal to their share of loss. So here by cash, so here Gardner versus Murare rule is applied. So if there is a loss on realization, so the solvent partners have brought cash of rupees here 3200 equal to their share of loss. Now we'll transfer this capital deficiency to their partners account to C account. That is in case for A 60 and in case of B is 40. Now here amount is greater, take a total of this. Similarly here, total of this. To cash account. So this is the balancing figure. So in 9200 minus 3260, that is it returns 5940. And here in case of B 7200 minus 3240. This will return 3960. Now we'll take the total. Okay. Now our final account is ledger is cash account. So cash balance, we have calculated cash in hand here in balance sheet, that is a balancing figure 3500, that is opening balance. To balance brought down 3500. Now we'll post this all cash figures in cash account. Is capital this cash part to a capital account 3200. Similarly to these capital account 3200. Buy side, so this 5940 and 3000 E capital by B capital. E capital is 5940 and B capital 3960. Now let we check the total of this, whether this cash book is valid or not. 9900 and here 9900. So this way we calculate cash account and we close the ledgers.